Good morning, class. In previous class, we have also seen the introductory part of the polymers. What is meant by the monomers? What is meant by the polymers? Then the types of polymers, that is addition, condensation, then functionality of polymer. We have seen in previous class. Now, today we will discuss what is meant by the degree of polymerization, and from the degree of polymerization, how we can calculate the molecular weight of the polymer sample. So, basically, the degree of polymerization, which is denoted by dP. Okay. So, what is meant by the degree of polymerization? A high polymer is one in which the number of repeating unit is more than 100 or it is exceed than 100, then it is called as the degree of polymerization. If you know the degree of polymerization, from this we can calculate the molecular weight of the polymer sample. The degree of polymer, it may be 100, 1000, 10,000, million, it can be added n numbers, right? So, the formula to calculate the molecular weight of polymer, from the degree of polymerization we can calculate the molecular weight of polymer. So, formula is MW, molecular weight of polymer, which is equal to dP into m. So, what is MW? MW is called as the molecular weight of polymer. dP stands for the degree of polymerization and m stands for the molecular weight of the monomer. So, by using this formula, we can calculate the molecular weight of the polymer sample. So, the well-known example is ethylene, CH2, double bond, CH2. So, here is repeating unit is 100, okay, undergoes polymerization reaction, it converted into polyethylene, CH2 single bond CH2, so here is repeating unit is 100. So, now in the whole reaction, the repeating unit, degree of polymerization repeating unit is 100, then molecular weight of this monomer, ethylene monomer is 28. And from this, we can calculate molecular weight of the this polymer sample. So, put this value over here. So, MW, which is equal to 100 into 28. So, it becomes 2800 will be the molecular weight of the above polymer sample. In the same case, here is if BP is 1000, then its molecular weight becomes 28,000. Okay, so in this way we can calculate the molecular weight of the polymer sample from the degree of polymerization. Then next point is mechanism of polymerization. As you know, there are two different types of mechanism. First is chain group polymerization mechanism, and second one is the step group polymerization mechanism. Now, what is the step group polymerization mechanism? The polymerization which is proceed via stepwise manner is called as what? Step group polymerization. Now, the well-known example is, suppose this is your monomer combined with again monomer, then it converted into dimer, right? So, this is step group polymerization. Again, monomer plus dimer, it converted into trimer, okay. Then dimer plus dimer, it converted into tetramer, okay. Suppose trimer plus dimer, it converted into pentamers. So, this is called as what? Step group polymerization mechanism. And as you know, the well-known example is what? The adipic acid and nylon's adipic acid and hexamethylene diamine. It can undergo the polycondensation reaction. Then the polymer is formed, that is accordingly the step group polymerization mechanism. Now, the second type of polymerization mechanism is chain group polymerization mechanism. Now, in chain group polymerization mechanism, there is again three different types, that is cationic mechanism, anionic mechanism and free radical mechanism. Now, today we will discuss the free radical mechanism. In free radical mechanism, basically we require the initiator. Initiator are thermally unstable compound which is decomposed or fragmented at the center, and it converted into two symmetrical components and containing lone pair of the electrons is called as the initiator. The well-known example of initiator mentioned here is hydrogen peroxide, H2O2. So this is HOOH, which is fragmented at the center, then it converted into twice hydroxyl radical. Right? Again, the another example is acetyl peroxide, CH3COO, C double bond O, CH3, acetyl peroxide, which is again fragmented at the center, then it converted into CH3 C double bond O dot, twice acetyl radical is obtained. Again, benzoyl peroxide, so it is the structure COO, C double bond O, this is again fragmented over here. So these are the examples of what initiator. Again, one more example, suppose this is hydrogen peroxide, this is acetyl peroxide, benzoyl peroxide, lauryl peroxide, these are the initiator. Suppose we can say R dash R, this is the initiator, here is fragmented, it can form twice R radical. Right? So this free radical mechanism, which is again proceeded via three different steps, which one? That is initiation step, propagation step and termination step. So these are the three different steps. The free radical polymerization mechanism, which is proceeded via three different steps: initiation, propagation and termination. For example, here is CH2 double bond CHCl. This is your vinyl chloride. Suppose here is your initiator is hydrogen peroxide HOOH. It is fragmented here. It form twice radical. So this OH radical, which is react at this carbonatum, this is radical side should be created at terminal position, then it becomes OH bond CH2 bond CHCl dot. So this is called as what? Initiation step. Second step is called as the propagation step. In propagation, the product of initiation, which is react with fresh monomer. So this is the product of initiation, which is react with fresh monomer. As you know, the fresh monomer is vinyl chloride, right? So this is shifted here, this is shifted here, right? So it can convert it into OH bond CH2 bond CH bond Cl bond CH2 bond CHCl dot. So here is we can add n number of monomers, right? So here is again the chain growth will be continued. This is called as what? Propagation. Last step is called as what? Termination. Basically, termination is the dead end of the polymer chain, right? So in termination step, we can add suitable chain terminator. That is RH is the chain terminator, or by using coupling or disproportion, we can also stop the growth of polymer chain. So this is the product OH bond CH2 bond CHCl bond CH2 bond CHCl. This is the product of propagation plus terminator. RH is the terminator, then it converted into OH bond CH2 bond CHCl bond CH2 bond CH2Cl plus R dot radical. So this is called as what? Your first initiation step, this is your propagation step, and this is your termination step. And these are the three different steps which is going to take place in free radical polymerization. And free radical polymerization, we require the initiator, and these are the initiator, and this is the mechanism.